It's the end of the year. Winter is coming, which means holiday is about to begin for an antkeeper. During the winter months, most species in Europe, America, and parts of Asia go into hibernation due to the change in weather and temperature. In this video, we will go over what hibernation is, why ants hibernate, and a few fun facts about hibernation. Watch this video till the end, because we will probably talk about a few things that will blow your mind. Yes, I said we, because this video is made in collaboration with Ants Anatomy. On his channel you will soon find a part 2 on how to hibernate your ant colonies. So what is hibernation? When we look up the definition on what hibernation is, we find: hibernation is a state of minimal activity and metabolic depression in endotherms. Hibernation is a seasonal heterothermy characterized by low body temperature, slow breathing, slow heart rate, and low metabolic rate. It most commonly occurs during winter months. Let's break that down, shall we? Hibernation is a state of minimal activity. This simply means that animals, ants, are not doing much and not moving much. Metabolic depression in endotherms basically means that the body preserves energy. Metabolic depression, by keeping the body at a steady body temperature, in endotherms. Hibernation is a seasonally heterothermy characterized by low body temperature. Heterothermy is a term for animals that vary between self-regulating their body temperature and allowing it to be affected by its surrounding temperature. People don't have this. Our bodies will always stay around 37 degrees Celsius. Alright, now the final part of the definition: slow breathing and slow heart rate and low metabolic rate. This pretty much speaks for itself. Only metabolism describes the way animals and humans burn energy. A low metabolic rate means you don't burn a lot of energy.
Now that we've got that out of the way, let's talk about ants. Why do they hibernate, and why should you hibernate them? Hibernation gets triggered by surrounding temperatures. This also changes the ant's body temperature, as they are heterothermy animals. Remember that animals can also vary in body temperature. When it's getting colder, their body temperature falls so greatly that their movements inevitably grow sluggish. That is why most ants hibernate underground, where the temperature is higher than above ground. In autumn, the ants store a large amount of food, thereby allowing them to go without food throughout the winter. A lot of sources state that ants store fat, but I have found no such sources that ants actually can store fat. Thereby, I claim it to be a myth. I mean, have you ever seen a fat ant? Do all ants hibernate? No. Only where the temperature changes drastically will ants go into hibernation. And even in most countries of Europe, ants won't go fully into hibernation, but more into just a winter rest, where they have less activity but can still be active and foraging around in your outworld. So now that we've talked about what hibernation is, why should you hibernate your ants in the first place? Well, without hibernation, the colony will still slow down and the queen will still rest, to a certain point. Without hibernation, the lifespan of the queen is drastically reduced. It's like running a machine non-stop without maintenance. Eventually, something has to break. Hibernation gives the colony a chance to recuperate and prepare for the coming year. The entrance of the ant nests are closed as a natural result of the slowdown and cessation of ant traffic. No ants maintaining the entrance means the entrance will collapse due to outside weather like rain and wind. So you are probably wondering how the ants don't freeze to death. Well, as you know, ants are very smart and can adapt easily to their surroundings. They have a few tricks up their sleeves, like making a nest under a rock. The rock will naturally warm up by the sun and keep the ants warm during the winter. They can also make their nests under a pile of leaves or use decomposing leaves to their nests to generate heat. A lot of ant species are known for nesting under tree barks. The bark acts as a natural insulator to keep the ants warm. For ants that dig underground, they also have a few options. For example, they can dig deeper tunnels and chambers to receive more warmth from the earth itself. Ants can also cluster together like penguins or newborn puppies to keep each other warmer.
This video was made in collaboration with Ants Anatomy. A part 2 will soon be online on his channel. Go ahead over there and subscribe so you won't miss it. The video will be about how to hibernate your ants. We really hoped you learned something in this video. If you did, please share this with your fellow antkeepers to spread awareness about hibernation, since not all antkeepers do it, but it's really important for your ants and queens. Thank you so much for watching this video.